Hello everyone, my name is André Lahaye. There are two ways to perform a specific search in Espacenet and tell the system in which fields exactly you want to search your search terms. You can either use the Smart Search Expert language, or you can customize your query in the Advanced Search mode. In this video, I will show you how to customize your Advanced Search query. Let's display Advanced Search by selecting this button. Smart Search and Advanced Search are synchronized. Therefore, let's begin our search first with a simple query in Smart Search. We are going to search European patent publications from the company Siemens about robotics. The asterisk at the end of robotic is meant to include the plural. As soon as you type in your query in Smart Search, the Advanced Search only displays the fields that are used in your query. Because we have entered search terms freely in the Smart Search bar, Espacenet has assigned default search criteria to the search terms according to their format. For example, the term EP has been recognized as a country code and by extension as a patent number. Espacenet has therefore assigned the search criterion all numbers, and will search this country code in publication, application, and priority numbers. Siemens and robotic have been recognized as keywords and will be searched by default in all text fields or names, in other words, in the title, abstract, description, claims, inventor names, and applicant names. To run the search, we select the search button or press enter. We obtain more than 700 results. However, you will notice that some documents do not have Siemens as patent applicant. For example, this document has been retrieved because Siemens is mentioned in the description. You will also notice that some patent families do not have EP publications, but only EP priorities or application numbers. For example, this patent family has an EP priority, but no EP publication. So, how can we make the query more specific and fit our needs? If you look attentively at the Advanced Search query, you will notice several drop-down arrows on the screen. These arrows allow you to open drop-down menus with different customization options. So, for the search term Siemens, we can change the search criterion, all text fields or names to applicant. To do that, select the drop-down arrow next to the search criterion. A first level menu opens with a list of all search criteria categories. If you select one of these categories, Espacenet will give you the corresponding default search criterion. For example, text fields will give title, abstract or claims, names will give inventors or applicants, and so on. If you select now the drop-down arrow next to names, the second level menu opens with all corresponding search criteria, which are inventors, or applicants. There, you can select applicants. Let's run the search. We obtain less patent documents, but all have now Siemens as applicant. Let's now change the search criterion for the search term EP into the more specific search criterion publication number. And let's run the search. We again have less results, but all results, so all families, have now at least one EP publication as family member. If we now want to find documents which correspond specifically to robotics, let's use the search criterion title, abstract or claims. To do that, we select the search criteria category text fields in the first level menu. Let's now run the search. We have tremendously narrowed down our search, but the retrieved documents correspond exactly to what we are searching for. In this second example, we would like to refine our query and find inventions specifically related to robotic arms. We could, for example, use a proximity operator and enter arm in the new field. The term robotic should then be less than 3 words away from arm. If you want to keep the topic broader, you can change the field operator to equal again. In this third example, we would like to find patent documents published over a certain period of time. To do that, you need to add a new field by selecting this button. Because the search criterion for the added field is always the same as the one used before, we need to change it to publication date. Now we can enter, for example, 2017 and change the field operator to in or after. When you build a search strategy, it is often important to use synonyms and or classification symbols and combine them with the Boolean operator or. To do that, you need to create a nested query by selecting group. You can now change the search criterion to IPC or CPC by selecting the classifications and add B25J9, which corresponds to program controlled manipulators. Let's now imagine that you would like to retrieve patent documents where the company Siemens has cooperated with universities. You can proceed as follows. Enter UNIF with an asterisk at the end of UNIF next to Siemens. We will not keep the field operator equal, otherwise Espacenet will search for documents which have an applicant name with the exact expression Siemens UNIF. We will not change it to the field operator any, because this operator has the same effect as the Boolean operator OR between search fields. Espacenet would then retrieve documents which have either the applicant name Siemens or applicants that have the term UNIF in their name, or both. We will select the field operator OL because this operator has the same effect as the Boolean operator AND between search fields. Espacenet will then retrieve documents which have both the applicant name Siemens and the term UNIF in the applicant name, which is what we want. To see if Siemens has collaborations with universities in other technical domains, we can remove the search field or groups of search fields related to the topic robotics by selecting the cross here. Well, that's it for now. Don't hesitate to consult the Espacenet help files to have deeper explanations on this topic. I hope this will help you to search relevant information for your work. Thanks for watching and have a great day.